So I want to talk about Jubit's Truck Stop. Now, this is one of the most popular truck stops in America. Most people have heard of it, at least. It's in Portland, all right? But the problem with this place is their parking lot design, all right? Look at all these. These are all blindside angle backs, all right? Everyone's backed into it, but I don't think that's how it was designed to be. What meaning is, and like, I think when they designed this, you were supposed to go nose into it. All right. The reason being is that if you do drive nose into it, you can get out really easily, like very simply. All right. Because if you drive in this way, you can sight out. All right. And the thing is, you don't even have to, because the distance between this point right here. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit more. The distance between, let's say here, all right, let's go ahead and get our measuring tool, to directly back here is 76 feet, which is longer than your truck. All right, so all you have to do is a straight back up, all right, and just drive away. All right, so I don't know, it's just, now a lot of people don't like to nose in because they feel like it's too difficult to get out, or they're not a real truck driver or whatever. But I personally, I would always nose in here, not because of difficulty and not because I can't do it or anything. It's just that you get a lot of, it's a lot more silent back there. You won't have a reefer unit, but if everybody does it, then obviously you will. But I don't think there's absolutely zero wrong with nosing into any of these spaces. All right. Now, if you can drive through and then stop, then that's fine. All right, then all you have to do is drive out, and there's no backing up whatsoever. And that's always the best scenario. All right, avoid backing at all costs. But that's not reality now, is it? Now, the reason why I actually wanted to talk to this, but because the hardest back in this particular Jubit's is not even accessible most of the time. Now, we actually, the company that I worked for, we actually rented this building right here. Okay, and actually we rented a ton of spots as well, because the yard that we were parking all of our trailers at was getting renovated. But now we had a ton of new trailers. I gotta switch something over here. All right, so we had to basically park all of our new trailers that didn't have any decals on it yet inside this building. All right, this is not easy. Now, we managed to do it. Eventually, when I turned up on scene, there was already three trailers in. Of course, that was at the end of the day, and it took them hours to do that, because there was like two spotters and, of course, the truck driver, and we didn't drive day cab trucks. Now, the thing is, there was a gate here, and we had to back up through the gate and in here. And the guy who was doing it first, he basically was saying it would take 45 minutes to do it, and he did it with his axles all the way back. And of course, me being a huge fan of backing up with my axles all the way forward, I took a shot at it. Now, again, I wasn't a rookie, I was very cocky. So I did manage to do it, and I did it pretty quickly as well. But of course, I couldn't do it without spotters. Here's another view. Now, this is actually from Bing Maps, which is a lot more clear, but as you can see, there's a fence right there. None of this stuff was here. This building wasn't there at all, but there is two poles that you got to deal with. All right, none of this was here. This was all clear. I can't remember if there was a fence or was it a curb, but yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how I maneuvered my way back in here, and I'm going to do with my axles forward first, and then at the end, I'm going to try to do it with my axles back. Now, when we parked all the trailers, basically, we would just have to line them up here just so they can get work done. I can't remember. It was like 15 years ago, 14 years ago or something, that we got those new batches of trailers. But yeah, I liked it. I loved a challenge back then. There was nothing greater to me than actually getting a challenge, and especially people watching, because I was just cocky. I really was. And but anyway, so again, we had to drive in here, and of course, depending on if there was spots available, well, a lot of time we would have to either pull a U-turn, or we'd have to back up into a space over here and get turned around. So let's go ahead and get ourselves turned around. And by the way, some of you guys may be even saying in the comments, why don't you just drive into it? That was not possible. It was not possible at all. So let's get ourselves turned around, and we are going to, now we could have actually driven in here, which I probably will do next time, maybe when I screw this up, because it doesn't, I don't always able to, I can get it in there, but it's getting it in there without hitting stuff. All right. And I don't know yet if I actually will attempt this with the blind spots on. Of course I should, why not? You know, it's just a game after all. I could just see that being extremely difficult. But anyway, so let's move the mouse. There we go. So we have to back in. I think there was one time I ever backed in here, because I backed in, I don't know, probably 20 times. I got pretty good at it. There was one time I didn't need to do a pull forward. I was pretty proud of that one. Of course, I did have a spotter. All right. And none of us attempted it without a spotter. But yeah. Anyway, so what I'm trying to do is, because there's a certain angle where the trailer will actually go in. It doesn't have to be 90 degrees. All right. So it's getting, of course, we have to watch out for the swing of the trailer. Oh, I'm going to have to do a pull forward, I'm guessing, here. All right. Now, so it's all about getting as close as possible to this guy. And then eventually, by the time the axles get back, I'll be close to these guys, these poles here. All right. Now, if it's too much, okay, I like that. All right. So I can go back a little bit. But of course, now I'm going to do a little bit of a pull forward. A little bit of a pull forward, because I still need to have my truck. Oh, no, that's not going to work out. Already hit a pole. Okay, let's try this. Let's see. Okay, we're in. And of course, depending on the spot itself. Oh, that was close. Let's get away from it. So I just went ahead and added a spot back here, because this is probably one of the more easier spots to get to. But eventually we had to get to all of them. Let's do it one more time to explaining what is actually going through my head when I am backing up. So this time, let's go ahead and same thing again. We had to take a wide every time. Most of the time we actually came in from the other direction. But whatever, I just wanted to kind of drive by so you can actually see the parking space. Now, this time I think we can actually make it to where we can drive. We can do a straight back over here. So got to get close to this guy, but come in from an angle that allows me to turn here a little sooner than it would be. Of course, you got to watch out for that swing of the trailer. Oh yeah, there we go. And okay, so what if we got to stop? No big deal. I think I can get in here. I actually haven't tried this with this trailer over here. Okay, the last thing we got to do is this. And then hard right. I think we're... Okay, let's see. Oh. All right, I think we're looking okay. Oh. There we go. All right. So we can do that. Now, if you do need to pull forward a lot of time you actually have to pull forward out here and then readjust yourself and start from scratch. Okay. Now, Let's see. What is going through my head? So, it's so hard. I see. If one thing changes, everything changes. So you can't actually follow exactly. All right. So you can't turn the steering wheel at this point and all that kind of stuff. But let's just see. A lot of the time, this is what would happen. Okay. So you end up basically. You would end up too close like this here. All right. So this is what would end up happening. All right. So you're like this, and then all of a sudden you're hitting, or because you can see that side, you'd end up being too close to the poles back here. All right. So, and that's what would happen. So there's no readjusting in here that you can do. All right. So you basically have to go out all the way over out again. And all right. So now that we're pointing a little way further away. All right. Now, see, this is too bad too, because I can't jackknife until I get to this point. And if I do jackknife extremely hard, I will end up being stuck in the curb over here. All right. So even though that the trailer is You know what I mean? So that's not a good one either. Okay, so let's go ahead and back out again, and let's kind of do a little bit of halfway from what it was. And, of course, you got to give yourself room over here too, so you can actually jackknife. So I'm thinking that this is the good one. All right, let's see if I can do it nice and slowly. Now, the way having myself over here made it handy, so I can actually start jackknifing. All right. Start chasing. Nope. I still think I can maneuver it in here and fix it. So there was many times I was in this corner. Man, many times. All right. Yeah, even when we pulled out of this area, when they were done decaling, we still had to have a spotter. It was just too narrow. It was really just too narrow. See, I can't do it twice in a row. So it's these are the tricks. I can't imagine this being a scenario. Oops, I hit the curb. Oh no. Am I gonna hit that pole too? I'm gonna hit them all. All right, now let's go ahead and try it with the axles all the way back. Obviously there we go. I got there and eventually lost a bunch of lives, but it's in there. A bunch of damage done to the brand new trailers already. All right, cool. Axles all the way back as soon as I finish. And there we go. So this time I definitely need to take it wide. Extra wide. Okay, so we definitely will not be able to drive into that one area because you just can't. Not with your axles all the way back. Okay, you wouldn't be able to get around that trailer. So you're just gonna have to trust me on that one. Okay, so we are gonna have to back in from over here. Man, driving with your axles back sucks. Oh, seriously, I didn't even get already lost a life, two lives. Bloody hell. Okay, let's. You know what? No, I won't do that. I'm going to do it. I'm probably not going to do it. To be honest with you, I didn't. It's not a good idea. The amount of pull forwards that you got to do to actually get this trailer with your axles all the way back inside in that is just ridiculous. Yes, you eliminate the swing of the trailer, but that's doesn't help. It just makes it harder because you have no room. You have no room to actually maneuver. All right. You have no room to pull forward. Okay. So, oopsie daisy. I suppose I don't want to lose another life. All right, we're down to one life. We're down to two lives. Come on. Oh, down to one life. Can I even back in here with that truck there? Okay, I guess we're doing this with one life. This is not... Okay. Okay, now we can use the area over here. Okay. Oh boy. All right, we need to get close. Okay. I'm gonna start your jackknife here. So at this point, we definitely need to be at 90 degrees. Okay. So there we go. Not that 90 degrees, too much. Okay, we're trying to do this. We only have one life left. And I did good. How did I do that so good? I'm confused. I am very confused how I was able to manage that. Oh, a lot of pull forwards. I attempted this like 20 times with my axles all the way back. And the amount of lives that I lost. Okay, so now here's the thing. I still need to get it over. Okay, so we all knew it was possible to do with the axles all the way back, but the problem was, you still ran into a lot of problems. Okay, can I even get that over? Okay, as soon as I get to here, I can turn. Whoop. Okay, we're in. All right, well, I guess we can do it with our axles all the way back. That looked easy, but trust me, it wasn't easy. even though I did it. But okay, how about we try one more time? I'm going to skip to the part where we're just going to be in there, okay? All right, we're back again. So let's do that again. I want to see if I can do this twice in a row. Okay, so we need to I don't, oh no, that's a bit. I can do this. Actually, this is fine. 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 I'm not doing anything wrong right now. So the trick is, I think, so it's already getting your jackknife, your hard jackknife in over here. All right. So, okay, still didn't lose a life. Okay, so it's getting to this point, all right? And now we did not care about the angle of our truck and trailer. We did not, all right? Now the problem is here is that I'm too far away and I can't maneuver. All right, I'm gonna have to try again. Hold on, I gotta try this again. And let's try this angle instead, where we'll actually start jackknifing. Let's get it somewhat inside in the space. Like I know I'm gonna have to do a pull forward. Okay, so. All right, I hit the curb. All right, so if we get really close to this pole over here, let's do that. So. All right. Okay, I like that, I think. Okay, let me just do a little bit of a pull forward. More. Got to get close. See, I'm loving the angle right here. It's because this allows me to jackknife pretty hard. And it means my truck will not be fighting with over here once I do jackknife. All right. Again, the closer you are. I could be closer. I'd be happier if I was closer. All right. So now we can chase. We're already in. We're already past the hard parts. And we can do pull forward here, no problem. Oh, okay. Well, I would have stopped before then. my spotter would have stopped me. All right, cool. All right. Now, the trouble is now is actually moving it over. All right, we already know that part. All right, but it's a lot of time is just backing up all the way first here. All right, and then pointing our trailer towards the spot. Man, there was a lot of screeching of tires inside in this building when we were maneuvering. There's so much screeching. Yeah, a lot of spottering. Okay, let's go ahead and do this. All right, I think that's it. That is it. This is that would not as if you're ever gonna get an opportunity to do this, but I'm sure there's a lot of East Coast places, warehouses where you got to do that. But yeah, anyway, please like, subscribe, check out my podcast, Just Another Trucking Podcast. Sorry, I said it's my podcast, but it's my buddy's podcast. But yeah, anyway, cool. That's all. Thanks for watching and lasting this long. All right, bye-bye.